Welcome to our special report here on Manufacturing News.
We are joined here today by our investigative reporter, John Connor, who is at Oberg Industries to find out what's so cool about manufacturing.
Thank you, Sarah Kate. I'm here at Oberg to see what's causing all the buzz.
Oberg is the best company I have ever worked for. I was in the military for 10 years. I worked for two other manufacturing companies. Then I became a teacher. I was an assistant principal. Now I'm here at Oberg, and this is just a wonderful job. What we do here helps people, and that matters.
My first apprenticeship was in precision tool grinding, a four-year apprenticeship where I achieved journeyman papers that are state certified. When you get into the apprenticeship program, it's a mixture of on-the-job training and college courses. So we actually have college instructors and professors come to Oberg Industries and teach college credit courses. You pay for college and you get paid to be in class.
What is the most productive sector here at Oberg?
Over the past 14 years, Oberg Medical went from a department to a full division, and it is now one of the most productive divisions of Oberg Industries. Both implants and instruments, mainly for hip surgery, knee surgery, and spinal fusion.
I see a lot of automation going on here. Won't that eliminate jobs for people?
Adding robotics and automation to manufacturing does not necessarily eliminate jobs at all. We at Oberg Industries believe very strongly in up-training our people. What we're going to do is train our existing people and employees and to be able to run that automation and understand what that is.
My name is Dave Felsone, and I am part of the NPD department, which is New Product Development.
This is called a five-axis milling machine. Computer numerical control is what we have. Offline programming, which a gentleman will sit at a regular computer and program with software, and then the software spits it into my machine.
Work with our apprentices and our training, and they pretty much allow the program to evolve and change, and they support the program from the CEO down to the last person in line. Manufacturing is growing and expanding by leaps and bounds in this area of our country.
That's it for our show.
Join us next week on Manufacturing News, where we take an inside look at CyberDyne Systems.